We're going to talk about the trumpets.
Govorit ćemo o trubama.
Have you heard about the trumpets? How many of you?
Koliko vas je slušalo o trubama?
Revelation chapter 8 through 11.
Otkrivenje od 8. do 11. glave.
One of the most difficult sections in the book of Revelation.
Jedan od najtežih dijelova otkrivenja.
Diversity of views.
Mnogo različitih pogleda.
The language is dense, difficult.
Jezik je zgusnut, težak.
The images that are used there are difficult.
Slike koje se tamo koriste su teške.
And we have never been able to provide a final interpretation of the trumpets.
I mi do sada nismo bili u stanju da stvorimo konačnu verziju tumačenja truba.
And I'm going to frustrate you.
I možda ću vas malo s time isfrustrirati.
I'm not bringing to you an interpretation of the trumpets.
Ja vam sada neću dati jedno tumačenje truba.
I'm going to tell you about the problems.
Ja ću vam reći sa kojim se problemima suočavamo.
The challenges.
Koje izazove imamo.
For you to be patient.
A vi budete strpljivi.
Because you are going to listen different views, be patient.
Čućete različite poglede, budite strpljivi.
We're still in a journey.
Još smo uvijek na jednom putovanju.
So we do have different views.
Tako imamo različite poglede.
And I'm going to tell you about them.
I reći ću vam o njima.
And I'm going to tell you about a more recent approach that find in the trumpets or that apply, that interpret the trumpets in terms of double fulfillment.
A reći ću vam nešto i o nekim novijim trendovima koji tumače trube kao jedno dvostruko ispunjenje.
Now the first part of this lecture.
U prvom dijelu ovog predavanja.
It's about how do you evaluate the different interpretations.
Mi ćemo pokušati da procijenimo ta različita tumačenja.
What are the tools that you have?
Koje alatke imamo da to uradimo?
And then we'll look into the different interpretations and I will show you a kind of a new consensus that is beginning to surface among Adventists.
A onda ćemo pogledati ta različita tumačenja i reći vam kakav je zajednički konsenzus ili usklađeno mišljenje koje imamo u vezi tumačenja truba.
I'm going to suggest to you to begin with.
Predlažem da počnemo sa
that we as Adventists
sa time da kažemo da smo mi kao Adventisti
have approached prophetic interpretation using a methodology called or an approach called historicism.
Mi kao Adventisti zastupamo pristup ka tumačenju proročanstava koji se zove historicizam.
Different ways to study the book of Revelation, different ways.
Postoje različiti načini kako možemo da proučavamo knjigu Otkrivenja.
You can approach it as a theological approach it to explore the theological content of the book.
Vi možete da priđete knjizi Otkrivenja i da istražujete i tumačite teološki sadržaj te knjige.
And you don't worry too much about the prophecies and fulfillment, you go for the message.
Vi se ne bavite toliko sa proročanstvima i njihovim ispunjenjem, nego vas zanima sama poruka.
Those who think it has something to do with prophecy, they have different approaches.
A oni koji smatraju da je to vezano za proročanstva, imaju različite pristupe.
Some believe that what we find in Revelation is what was happening in the first century AD.
Neki vjeruju da ono što pronalazimo u Otkrivenju se u stvari dešavalo u prvom vijeku naše ere.
And we call the method they use, we call it preterism.
I taj njihov metod koji oni koriste zovemo preterizam.
And there are those who say most of the book of Revelation is still in the future.
A onda postoje oni koji kažu većina knjige Otkrivenja je još uvijek u budućnosti.
And we call them
i njih zovemo
futurists or futurism.
Futuristi ili njihov pristup je futurizam.
So there are different approaches.
Tako da imamo različite pristupe.
We as Adventists have selected an approach called historicism.
A mi kao Adventisti smo odabrali pristup koji se zove historicizam.
That is to say,
što znači?
The prophecies that we have in the book of Daniel and Revelation,
proročanstva koje imamo u knjigama Otkrivenja i Danila,
they tend to cover the historical period from the time of the prophet to the very end, the second coming of Christ.
Ta proročanstva pokrivaju jedan vremenski period koji počinje još u vrijeme proroka, ali se proteže sve do vremena kraja.
It's a kind of an outline, a backbone of history.
To je jedan pregled kao jedna kičma istorije koja nam se tu daje.
You have only key elements of that history. You don't have many details.
Vi tu imate samo ključne elemente istorije, nemate sve detalje.
And we have used historicism because we feel that this is the methodology that flows from the scriptures itself, themselves.
I mi smo izabrali historicizam kao pristup jer smatramo da on proističe iz samoga pisma.
Daniel didn't understand the prophecy, chapter 8, chapter 7.
Danilo nije razumio proročanstva iz 7. i 8. glave njegove knjige.
So the angel came.
I onda je anđeo došao
and told him,
i rekao mu,
the lion is Babylon,
onaj lav je Vavilon,
and so on and so on.
I tako dalje, i tako dalje.
And he said, the judgment is coming. So you have the angel himself explaining to Daniel how this operates.
I onda mu je rekao, sud dolazi. Tako da anđeo tumači kako to sve funkcioniše i šta se dešava.
This is the methodology that we have used.
To je ta metodologija koju mi koristimo.
Because we feel that it flows from the scriptures.
I mi smatramo da ona proističe iz samoga pisma.
This methodology has been rejected by modern scholarship.
Ova metodologija je odbačena od strane modernih tumača, teologa, naučnika biblijskih.
Outside Adventism, you don't hear about historicism.
Van naše crkve adventističke vi više ne čujete to tumačenje historicističko.
Modern scholarship uses preterism. Mainly.
Moderne teološke struje idu ka preterizmu.
So if we're going to evaluate the different views on the trumpets,
tako da ako budemo evaluirali različite poglede o trubama,
the only tool we have, I mean we have many, but this is the most important one, the main tool we have.
Ali mi imamo glavnu alatku, glavni način kako ćemo da pristupimo trubama.
It's the historicist method.
A to je taj naš adventistički historicistički metod.
So let me go briefly over some of the key elements.
Hajde sada prođemo ukratko kroz glavne elemente.
I mentioned to you that according to this method, the prophecies in Daniel and Revelation cover the whole span of history.
Već sam spomenuo da prema ovom metodu proročanstva Danila i Otkrivenja pokrivaju cjelokupnu istoriju čovečanstva.
Some of these elements, prophetic elements, have already been fulfilled.
Neki od tih proročkih elemenata su se već ispunili.
Others are in the process of being fulfilled.
Ili se upravo sada ispunjavaju.
And others are in the future.
A neki su u budućnosti.
If any interpretation of the trumpets disagree with this fundamental aspect of historicism, then you have to raise the question.
Ako bilo koje tumačenje truba se ne slaže sa ovim osnovnim našim pristupom historicističkim, onda mi moramo da ga stavimo po znak pitanja.
For instance, if somebody tells you all the trumpets are in the future,
na primjer, ako vam neko kaže sve trube su u budućnosti,
and you have a problem because historicism doesn't fit well there.
onda imamo problem jer se historicizam u to baš dobro ne uklapa.
And this means that, I mean, the applying the historicist approach to the trumpets, it means that preterism and futurism are ruled out.
Tako da, ako mi historicistički pristup primjenimo na trube, to onda znači u isto vrijeme da preteristički i futuristički pristup su odbačeni.
Another aspect, important aspect of the historicist methodology is what we call recapitulation.
Drugi aspekt onoga što mi posmatramo kao historicistički pristup jeste ponavljanje određenih elemenata.
As prophecies of Daniel and Revelation, they come in cycles.
I proročanstva Daniela i Otkrivenja nam dolaze u krugovima.
You have Daniel 2.
Imate Danilo drugu glavu.
It's a cycle because it begins and it closes with the coming of Christ. Then you have chapter 7, another cycle.
Dakle, imamo glavu drugu koja počinje i završava se sa dolaskom Hristovim, tako da imamo cijeli krug, ali onda imate i Danilo sedmu glavu, isto tako.
The same with chapter 8.
Isto je i sa osmom glavom.
And each cycle takes you to the time of the prophet, begins with the time of the prophet and takes you to the end.
I svaki taj krug počinje sa vremenom u kojem se prorok nalazi i završava sa krajem vremena.
Chapter 7 begins again with the times of the prophet and takes you to the end.
Sedma glava također počinje u vremenu proroka i završava u vremenu kraja.
This is what we call recapitulation. It takes you again at the beginning of the cycle, repeats, expands, introduces new vision, new ideas.
To ono što mi zovemo rekapitulacija ili ponavljanje, obnavljanje. Znači, počinje sa istim elementima, ali onda nam daje dodatne elemente i dodatne informacije koje dobijamo.
Revelation, you have the same thing.
U Otkrivenju imamo istu stvar.
Seven seals.
Sedam pečata.
Seven trumpets.
Sedam truba.
Christian era at the beginning, at the end. Beginning, end.
Hrišćanska era počinje, završava. Počinje, završava.
Recapitulation is very important in evaluating the different positions.
Tako da ta rekapitulacija je vrlo važna u tome kako procjenjujemo različite poglede ili stavove po ovom pitanju.
If somebody comes and says to you the seven seals, they do not close the system. The system remains open and the trumpets follow sequentially.
Ako vam neko kaže imamo sedam pečata, a onda se tu sistem ne zatvara, nego se nakon njega nastavljaju sedam truba hronološki.
In that case, recapitulation has been set aside.
Onda taj princip rekapitulacije se gura u stranu.
And that raises some questions about the reliability of the interpretation.
A to nama daje određena pitanja, sumnje u vezi pouzdanosti takvog jednog tumačenja.
Among Adventists, historicism means also that each prophecy has a specific fulfillment.
Adventizmu, znači taj historicizam, znači da također svako proročanstvo ima svoje specifično ispunjenje.
Daniel says to the king,
Danilo kaže caru,
this is your dream.
Ovo je to tvoj san.
This is the interpretation.
A ovo je tumačenje.
You, O king, you are the head.
Ti, care, ti si ona glava.
One specific fulfillment.
Jedno vrlo konkretno ispunjenje.
Not multiple fulfillments.
Nije tu bilo nekih višestrukih ispunjenja.
So an interpretation of the trumpets that proposes different multiple interpretations of the same symbol will raise a question.
Tako da kada u vezi truba se predlaže da jedan te isti simbol označava nekoliko stvari, ima više ispunjenja, to mi moramo da stavimo po znak pitanja također.
Now more, let's deal more specifically with the trumpets.
Hajde sada malo konkretnije se pozabavimo sa trubama.
As we look at the trumpets indicate that we're dealing with judgment of God within history.
Kada posmatramo trube, mi primjećujemo da su one povezane sa Božjim sudovima kroz istoriju.
It's not dealing with the final judgments of God that we find in the plagues.
One se ne bave Božjim konačnim sudovima nad planetom koja se nalazi u onih sedam zala.
So with the trumpets you have one third of this was destroyed, one third of that was destroyed.
U trubama vi imate ono trećina ovoga bi uništena, pa trećina onoga bi uništena.
It's not God's final judgment.
To nije Božji konačni sud.
The other aspect that we find in the trumpets that would require careful analysis is the time periods.
Drugi element koji treba pažljivo se analizira je taj u trubama je taj vremenski element.
The sixth and the seventh trumpet you have time periods mentioned.
U šestoj i sedmoj trubi vi imate periode vremena spomenute.
And the question is, are these time periods prophetic periods or not?
I posle se pitanje da li su ovi vremenski periodi proročki periodi ili nisu.
And this the interpreter will have to deal with.
I sa time će se tumači morati pozabaviti.
We should not assume that they are prophetic time periods or that they are not. We need to look at it at them.
Mi ne možemo da jednostavno pretpostavimo da oni jesu ili nisu proročki periodi, mi moramo to da istražimo.
And it's also important to look at the language used.
I važno je da posmatramo koji se tu jezik koristi.
And study the language at the light of the totality of the scriptures to see what the language is encoding for us.
I da posmatramo taj jezik koji se tamo nalazi u svjetlosti cijeloga pisma, da vidimo šta je to šifrovano u tom jeziku za nas.
Now that I have confused you,
sada kada sam vas malo zbunio,
let me confuse you a little more.
Hajde još malo više da vas zbunim.
I studied 9 Adventist interpreters of Revelation.
Ja sam proučavao 9 adventističkih tumača
to see how they dealt with the trumpets.
Da vidim kako su oni tumačili trube.
And I have a chart.
I evo imam ovdje jednu tabelu.
I began with Uriah Smith.
Počinjemo sa Urijom Smithom.
I suppose you have seen his commentary maybe in your own language, I don't know.
We do have. Možda ste vidjeli njegov komentar prevedeni na naš jezik.
And his interpretation which he took from other non-Adventist interpreters.
I njegovo tumačenje koje on u stvari uzeo od drugih neadventističkih tumača
became the traditional Adventist interpretation, not the official Adventist interpretation.
To tumačenje je postalo tradicionalno adventističko tumačenje, premda ne i službeno adventističko tumačenje.
Now, the others, I'm going to mention the names quickly. Thiele, Naden, Maxwell, Shea.
Tu su i ostali, spomenut ću kratko njihova imena. Tu je Thiele, Naden, Maxwell, Shea.
And Treyer.
I tu je Treyer.
And then Pauline, Larondel, Stefanović.
I onda tu imamo u jednoj grupi Paulina, Larondela i Stefanovića.
And there is some significant differences of opinions.
I postoje neke značajne razlike u mišljenjima.
Should not surprise you.
I ne bi nas to trebalo ni iznenaditi.
Because the passage on the trumpets, the passages, the chapters are very difficult.
Jer taj dio o trubama je vrlo težak.
Now let me tell you rather quickly the position of Smith.
Hajde sada ukratko da vam kažem šta je zastupao Smith.
The first trumpet,
prva truba,
were the attacks against Rome by the Visigoths.
To je napad Vizigota protiv Rima.
The second, the attack against Rome by the Vandals.
Druga, napad Vandala protiv Rima.
The third, the attack against Rome by the Huns.
Treća, napad Huna protiv Rima.
And the fifth, the fall of Western Rome.
The fourth.
Yes.
Četvrta, pad zapadnog Rima.
In other words, all the first four trumpets had to do with Rome.
Drugim rečima, prve četiri trube su povezane uz Rim.
The collapse of Rome.
Pad Rima.
There is only one of the scholars that I mentioned to you who follows that more or less that same approach.
Sada postoji samo jedan od naših teologa koji manje više slijedi taj pristup.
The others have abandoned Uriah Smith's interpretation.
Ostali su napustili taj Smithov pristup.
There is a kind of consensus developing around the first four trumpets.
Postoji određeni konsenzus ili slaganje u vezi te prve četiri trube,
which is good because we begin to see the minds coming together.
Što je dobro, jer tu vidimo nekako da se umovi počinju slagati.
And this consensus is based on the careful study of the language used in the trumpets.
A to slaganje je zasnovano na pažljivom proučavanju jezika koji se koristi u trubama.
And I'm now deciding what to do. I have only 4 minutes left.
Ja sad razmišljam šta da uradim jer mi je ostalo 4 minute.
I'll take some of your time. I got an offering.
Dobio je jedan dar od brata Stefanovića da produži 15 minuta.
I'm talking about him, so he's saying, keep on talking.
Kaže, ja pričam o njemu, pa on kaže, nastavi da pričaš o meni.
This is the new consensus that I see.
Ovo je taj novi konsenzus koji imamo.
The first trumpet,
prva truba,
is about the judgment against Jerusalem.
Se bavi Božim sudom nad Jerusalimom.
The second trumpet,
druga truba,
is about the fall or judgment against the Roman Empire.
Tiče se suda ili pada paganskog Rima.
The third trumpet has to do with the apostasy of the Christian church.
Treća truba se tiče suda nad otpalom hrišćanskom crkvom.
And the fourth trumpet has to do with the Middle Ages or what immediately followed the Middle Ages.
A četvrta truba je vezana za mračni srednji vijek i onim što je bilo odmah nakon toga.
So this is good.
Dobro, to je dobro.
There is a kind of consensus.
Dakle, imamo određeno slaganje ovdje.
Problem, the real problem is found in trumpets 5 and 6.
Ali onaj pravi problem nastaje u 5. i 6. trubi.
Uriah Smith to apply them to the rise of Islam.
Uriah Smith ih je primijenio na nastajanje i podizanje islama.
And the sixth trumpet he applied it to the Ottoman Empire.
A šestu trubu je primijenio specifično na Otomansko carstvo.
This is the area where there is more disagreement among Adventists.
E na tom području ima malo više neslaganja među Adventistima.
A few of the interpreters still consider the 5 months to be prophetic time.
Neki tumači još uvijek smatraju da onih 5 mjeseci je proročko vrijeme.
And in the sixth trumpet, the statement one day, one month, one year, they consider this to be also prophetic.
A u šestoj trubi, ono jedan dan, jedan mjesec, jedna godina, također posmatruju da su to proročki periodi vremena.
The problem that the more recent interpreters are facing,
problem sa kojim se suočavaju tumači novijeg vremena,
is how to date those prophetic periods.
Jeste kako da odrede godine u tim proročkim periodima.
And they have diversities of dates and time and historical periods.
I oni tu imaju različite predloge kako da se te periode datira, odredi vremenski.
There is a triumvirate. We say that in English, triumvirate? Triumvirate. There are three writers of the Apocalypse.
Postoje tri jahača u otkrivenju Apokalipsi.
Who have offered us a totally new interpretation.
Oh, you said writers, not riders.
Both.
Okay, kaže oboje, i jašu i pišu. Ali ovdje mislim na pisce, znači tri pisa koja govore o tome.
These are John Paulin, Hans Larondel, Stefanović.
Tri pisa, znači, koja pišu, a to su Paulin, Larondel i Stefanović.
And they have looked at the language of use in the fifth and sixth trumpets.
I oni su pogledali kako se koristi jezik u petoj i šestoj trubi.
And they have concluded that the fifth trumpet has to do with secularism and atheism.
I zaključili su da peta truba je povezana sa sekularizmom i ateizmom.
The rise and reign of secularism, atheism, beginning with the French Revolution.
Nastajanje, razvoj i djelovanje sekularizma i ateizma posebno povezano sa Francuskom revolucijom.
So the time periods there are not prophetic periods.
U tom slučaju ti proročki periodi koji se tu spominju, vremenski periodi, nisu proročka vremena.
They have a different function.
Oni imaju jednu drugu funkciju.
And you can ask later Ranko about that.
A vi poslije pitate Ranka u vezi toga.
Trumpet number six.
Šesta truba.
This new approach.
Ovaj novi pristup kaže.
Argues that in trumpet number three we have a description of the final crisis, the rise of the end time Babylon.
Ta šesta truba se odnosi na nastanak i razvoj Babilona posljednjeg vremena.
You have a reference to the seal of God.
Tu je onda povezano sa onim pečatom Božim.
And that takes you to chapter 7.
To nas vodi u sedmu glavu.
Then you have a reference in that trumpet to a river Euphrates.
U toj trubi se govori o rijeci Eufratu.
And that takes you to Revelation 16.
A to nas vodi do otkrivenja 16. glave.
So they argue that this trumpet is about the rise of Babylon.
Tako da oni nam kažu da se ovo tiče razvoja Babilona u posljednje vrijeme.
I would suggest to you that in spite of the fact that this new approach is not identifying a literal kingdom, empire, they are still within the framework of reference of historicism.
Ja bih želio da vam kažem da premda ovaj novi pristup ne identifikuje konkretna carstva i precizno određuje određene sile, on se još uvijek nalazi u onom okviru historicističkog tumačenja koje mi prihvatamo.
All you have to do is to go to the New Testament times and you will find in the New Testament's reference to Israel.
Sve što je potrebno jeste da odete u Novi Zavjet, tamo vidite kako se poziva na Izrael.
But in the writings of the New Testament, sometimes Israel refers to the Jews, yes.
I u tim spisima Izrael se nekada odnosi na Jevreje, da.
But the Israel of the New Testament is the people of God.
Ali Izrael u Novom Zavjetu je u stvari narod Božji.
Jews and Gentiles.
I Jevreji i neznabošci.
Who have found in Christ the Messiah.
Koji su u Hristu pronašli Mesiju.
So that the faith of Israel, the literal Israel, the faith of the literal Israel has been universalized.
Tako da vjera doslovnog Izraela je postala univerzalna.
And Israel is no longer in Palestine.
I tako da Izrael više nije u Palestini.
It's all over the world.
Nego je po cijelom svijetu.
And the same you have with the mystical Babylon.
A isto je i sa tim mističnim Babilonom.
It's no longer a city on found in Iraq.
To više nije grad koji se nalazi u Iraku.
It's a global movement of apostasy.
To je jedan globalni pokret otpada.
So perhaps they are right.
Tako da možda su u pravu.
And I will ask you to study their books. You have one by Ranko, you can read it and decide what how you feel about it.
I ja vam predlažem da proučavate te knjige, imate na vašem jeziku knjigu od Ranka i onda ćete vidjeti kako vi to možete da razumijete, kako se to vama uklapa.
The in my opinion the main challenge that this new approach faces is the reference to the time periods.
Mislim da nekako najveći izazov sa kojim se taj novi pristup mora suočiti jeste povezan sa onim vremenskim periodima koji su tu navedeni.
But they have ways to deal with that.
Ali postoje načini na koji se oni mogu s time pozabaviti.
To complicate things even a little more for you.
Ali da bih još malo zakomplikovao stvari za vas.
There is a statement in Ellen G. White.
Postoji izjava kod Ellen White
that some interpreters have used to demonstrate or to argue,
koji su određeni tumači koristili da bi zastupali stav
that the fifth trumpet has to do with the rise of Islam and not with what the new approach is suggesting.
Dakle, postoji izjava kod Ellen White za koju oni smatraju da podupire stav da se to odnosi na uspon islama, a ne na nešto drugo kao što novi pristup to predlaže.
The statement is found in the book The Great Controversy.
Ta izjava se nalazi u knjizi Velika borba.
And I don't know the page, mislim.
Nisam siguran koja stranica. 334 i 5 stranica originala.
Ellen G. White is describing the experience of the Millerites.
I Ellen White tu opisuje iskustvo Millerita.
And how little by little this movement was growing and gaining energy.
I kako je taj pokret polako rastao i dobio sve veći momentum.
And
silu.
She makes a reference to a prediction made by Josiah Litch.
I onda ona se poziva na nešto što je naš pionir Josiah Litch izjavio.
He made the prediction based on the trumpet, the 150 days and the 391 days, years.
I ona, znači, govori o tome da je on napravio predviđanje šta će da se desi na osnovu dva vremenska perioda od... tell me again the time periods.
150 days plus 391 and so on.
Okay. Dakle, 150 godina plus 391 godina.
And he predicted that in August 1840 the Ottoman Empire would be broken.
I on je predvidio da 1. augusta 1840. će biti slomljena moć Otomanskog carstva.
Supposedly that's what happened and this gave even more impetus to the Millerite movement.
I navodno se to tako i desilo, što je naravno dalo još više sile Millerskom pokretu.
The statement by Ellen G. White is used to support the position of Uriah Smith.
I ta izjava Ellen White se koristi da bi se poduprla pozicija Urije Smitha.
But the interpretation of this statement is a matter of debate.
Ali tumačenje te njene izjave može biti predmet debate.
Is she saying this prophecy was a biblical prophecy and was fulfilled in 1840? Is that what she's saying?
Da li ona kaže To proročanstvo je biblijsko proročanstvo koje se ispunilo 1840.
Or she is simply describing what was happening at that moment in within the Millerite movement.
Ili da li ona jednostavno opisuje šta se to desilo u to vrijeme unutar Milleritskog pokreta?
If the second is right, then she is not supporting Uriah Smith.
Ako je drugo tačno, onda ona ne podupire time direktno Uriju Smitha.
She's simply saying this is what was happening.
Ona jednostavno kaže to je ono što se desilo.
And she never again comes back to 1840 as the fulfillment of any prophecy.
I nikada ponovo se ona ne vraća na 1840. Godinu da bi rekla da je to bilo ispunjenje tog proročanstva.
The statement doesn't solve the problem.
Tako da ta izjava ne rešava problem.
And we have different positions.
A mi imamo različite pozicije.
It is okay to have different opinions. Something wrong.
U redu je, ništa nije pogrešno ako mi imamo različite pozicije.
The Adventist Church believes that they have a message.
Adventistička crkva vjeruje da ima poruku.
Well defined, an mission.
Dobro definisanu, imamo svoju misiju.
And the World Church, as such, proclaims that message.
I cijela svjetska crkva objavljuje tu poruku.
Embraces that message.
Čvrsto se drži te poruke.
And expect church members to follow the message.
I očekuje da članovi crkve slijede tu poruku.
So if a church member stands up and says, I believe that Sabbath is not the seventh day, but Sunday or Friday.
I tako ako bi neki član crkve ustao i rekao, ja ne vjerujem da je subota dan od odmora, nego petak ili nedjelja.
We don't tolerate this type of differences of opinion.
Mi ne možemo da tolerišemo takvu jednu razliku u mišljenju.
Has to do with the message that we have embraced.
To je vezano za poruku koju smo mi prihvatili.
But there are many, many other things that the church has not officially defined.
Ali postoji mnogo drugih stvari koje crkva nije službeno definisala.
And in those areas, the church says we can live together. It's not a problem.
I u tim područjima crkva kaže mi možemo zajedno da živimo, to nam nije problem.
If you believe that Christ had a fallen human nature,
ako vjerujete da je Hristos imao palu ljudsku prirodu,
and you believe that he didn't,
ili vi vjerujete da nije,
it's okay.
U redu je.
We can live together.
Možemo zajedno da živimo.
Because the church has never taken an official position on these matters.
Jer crkva nikada nije zauzela službeni stav po tom pitanju.
So you can study this.
Tako vi možete ovo da proučavate.
You can reach your own conclusions or select one of the many.
Možete doći do vašeg ličnog zaključka, možete izabrati neki od mnogih ponuđenih.
As long as the interpretation that is selected.
Ali to je tako u slučaju da tumačenje koje ste izabrali
does not deny the historicist method of interpretation,
ne negira historicistički metod tumačenja.
The church will feel comfortable with diversity of views.
I tu crkva neće imati problema sa različitim pogledima.
But what is important for us as Adventists, as I close,
ali ono što je bitno za nas, evo sada kada završavam, za nas kao Adventiste,
that the trumpets take us to the second coming of Christ.
Jeste da trube nas dovode sve do drugog Hristovog dolaska.
I don't know an Adventist who does not live in expectation.
Ne poznajem Adventistu koji ne živi u očekivanju.
The hope that we have mentioned.
To je ta nada koju mi imamo.
This is what matters.
To je ono što je važno.
History is moving toward that glorious event.
Istorija se kreće prema tom slavnom događaju.
It's the most glorious event in human history. It will be the most glorious event in human history.
To će biti najslavniji događaj u ljudskoj istoriji.
The kingdoms of this world will come under the rule of the King of Kings.
Carstvo ovoga svijeta će doći pod vladavinu cara nad carevima.
And we'll go home.
I mi ćemo otići kući.
And I will no longer be a pilgrim.
a ja više neću biti putnik hodočasnik na ovoj zemlji. Neka vas Bog blagoslovi.